I don't know why I'm watching this. Am I bothering you two?
No, not at all. This is Carla.
Oh, you're Ali. Gabby told me a lot about you. You're very pretty, you know. I have another friend who's on the spectrum too, but he's not...
She meant it as a compliment, that you're very pretty.
Thank you, but you should be saying that to your girlfriend.
Can you take a photo of us?
Are we really doing this?
Yes. Our last photo on Instagram got 72 likes. Come on.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks.
I'd leave you two alone, but I can't. Because I don't know the way home, because the traffic lights are really bright and they hurt my eyes, so I have to keep them shut. Can't help it.
You really need to help me out this time. Okay, I just want to know, like before having a meltdown, an episode, can you remember what usually triggers you to meltdown?
Laura, this really isn't the time. I have a paper to write, and Gabby and her Tinder girlfriend are making all these noises, and I can't concentrate.
Alright, so you're just extra sensitive to the banging and moaning. It unsettles you.
I'd really rather study than be the subject of your study right now.
You seem upset. What's wrong?
I told you, they're making all these noises and I can't concentrate.
Just because of that? Or is it something bigger? Come on, let's move to the Freudian chair.
No, I really don't have time for this.
Come on. So how are you feeling about university? Are you scared at all?
Not really. My plan is if I don't talk to anyone, then no one will realise I'm on the spectrum. If I just stay in my own lane and read what I want to read, then I won't cause any trouble.
Why is that? Don't you want to make some new friends?
I have you and Gabby. And I can meet your friends and Gabby's, like Carla.
And would you want to start a relationship at some point? You know, like Gabby and Carla?
I'm not interested in girls.
I mean a boyfriend. Ali, I think you should put yourself out there. Just because you're an Aspie doesn't mean you can't have new friends and boyfriends.
Maybe. But they'd think I'm a freak, which I am.
Ali, listen. You are so pretty and such a nice girl. I'd be on my knees if I were a guy. Gabby! Don't you think Ali should get a boyfriend?
Oh, yes.
It's true, though. It's in the hierarchy of needs of Maslow. First you need love and sex. For achieving other things in life.
Are you saying that if I want to become a successful lawyer, I must first have sex and be in a relationship?
According to Maslow, yes.
Duly noted. Only 9% of autistic people date and get married. Evolution is unfair. It doesn't want Aspies like me to pass along their genes. Because my child is quite likely to be on the spectrum too. It's like passing them a flu that will never be cured. And that'll be troublesome. So I get a boyfriend. He'll need to be off the spectrum. He needs to be fit, handsome, tall, normal. He needs to offset the abnormalities I have, or at least reduce the odds. Thank you.
coffee or anything?
No, coffee makes me restless.
Okay. Did you have a good summer vacation? Did you go to the beach? Anything fun?
No.
Why not?
I personally don't like the beach that much because you have to bring so many things. Towels, sun cream, swimwear and stuff. And I wear contacts, so I have to worry about not letting the salt get in my eyes, otherwise it hurts a lot. And then I have to put on layers and layers of sun cream, and then I still might get burnt. And I'm scared that my phone will get stolen while I'm in the sea, so I can never really enjoy the sea. So I prefer to just sit with my belongings and read a book, which I can do at home.
Oh, okay. I guess there's some truth to what you're saying. But, interesting. I mean, to be fair, I burn quite easily as well. But, you know when your skin's burnt and you start peeling? It's quite satisfying, no? I mean, it's a bit gross, but I find it quite satisfying. Don't you? Oh, tough crowd. Okay, do you read any books?
Yeah. Law, mostly. Law journals, crime records, interesting cases.
Tell me about it. I should read more of that stuff.
You should. You should read more.
Yeah?
Did you know that the average person walks past 16 murderers in their lifetime?
Shut up. Mm-hmm. You serious?
That means if you live till you're 80, you've probably passed by 4 or so murderers on the streets by now.
What? That's crazy.
I like to read that kind of thing. Crime records. It makes me feel safer knowing what's been going on and what the risks are.
Okay. Is that why you want to study law? To make the world a safer place?
When I was in year 5, everyone was supposed to receive these calculators they'd ordered online. And everybody got them, except me and this boy, and there was only one left. And he fought, and eventually he got it while I cried.
I'm sorry.
It was really unfair because I didn't know how to fight, you know, how to argue. So that's why I wanted to become a lawyer. I guess rules and laws that make me feel safer and make the world seem a bit more predictable. I'm new to this dating thing. What am I supposed to say now? I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
No? Don't worry. Say no more.
What am I supposed to do with my hands?
Put them anywhere you want, like here, here, my butt, wherever you want to go. Whatever feels natural. That's fine. Go with it. What'd I do? You okay? What's going on? You alright? Oh, what's going on?
Just breathe. What have you done?
You're just fooling around. Is she okay?
Just breathe. I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
It's okay, Ali, just breathe, okay? Just breathe. Listen. Ali, it's okay. Just breathe. It's okay.
I don't think I'm ever going to talk to a guy again.
Wally, I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have said those things. I shouldn't have pushed you to make new friends, let alone boyfriends. I'm such a terrible therapist.
No, you're right about some things. It's just sometimes it gets too much and then I don't know how to handle it. Maybe
I'm just doomed to be single forever.